a male chimp born in July 1956 in Africa was captured by animal trappers and sent to the rare bird family in Miami. But one day, in 1959, United States Air Force purchased them for a space flight experiment. All this just because the United States of America had to respond to the Soviets and the space race between them. In fact, you say, formed NASA for that occasion and started preparing a team of chimps to go to space. Chimpanzees were chosen because they were very similar to humans. They started out with 40 chimps that were tested for fairly simple tasks, such as pulling levers to respond to sounds and lights. Banana pellets were rewarded to those which accomplished their tasks within 5 seconds, but those who were late received mild shocks to the soles of their feet. Also, the chimps were exposed to microgravity and G-forces simulators. There were 40 at the beginning. After evaluations, the number of candidates reduced to 18, then to 6. Ham, our chimp, was in that group. This group proceeded to the heavier training. Ham exceeded in those tests. He was trained to press specific buttons every time he saw blue blinking light. NASA proudly said, Ham easily stood out as the best of the bunch. After more than a year of training, Ham was the chosen one for this crucial mission, the MR-2. Ham firstly was just known as number 65, but then he received his names from the acronym of Holloman Aerospace Medical Center. Also, he was suited with a special spacesuit that had the same properties as the upcoming maiden flight of astronaut Alan Shepard. His day has come. On January 31st, 1961, Ham was launched into space, departed from the Cape of Carnival Space Center, sealed into the capsule of the 25-meter-long Mercury Redstone 2 spacecraft. But almost immediately after the takeoff, there was a hitch. The spacecraft was higher than it was supposed to be, meaning oxygen levels began to drop. The mission carried on. Ham experienced then more than 6 minutes of weightlessness. He responded perfectly to blue lights as he was intended, and finally he splashed down in the Atlantic Ocean. Different landing site due to steeper depart climb. Therefore, Ham had to uncomfortably wait 3 hours before he was found. However, when the spacecraft was opened, Ham accepted an apple and a half an orange as a reward. The spaceflight conclusively took 16 minutes and 39 seconds, where Ham had to experience some crushing forces on the takeoff and re-entry and evident terror. Fortunately, Ham was unharmed. Ham the Chimp became instant celebrity when he returned from his space mission. He appeared on several USA television programs, TV shows, and several documentaries. Afterwards, our hero Ham retired to the USA National Zoo in Washington, D.C. There, he enjoyed a celebrity lifestyle, pampered by keepers, receiving mail from adoring fans, and answering some of them with his fingerprinted autograph. For 17 years, he stayed there. In 1980, Ham moved to the North Carolina Zoo, where he died in 1983 at the age of 25. After his death, Ham's body was turned over to the Armed Forces Institute of Pathology for necropsy, where later they planned to have him stuffed and placed on display at the Smithsonian next to the space dogs Belka and Strelka. However, this plan was abandoned after negative public reaction. Ham's remains, except the skeleton, were buried at the International Space Hall of Fame in Alamogordo, New Mexico, where the skeleton is held in the collection of the National Museum of Health and Medicine.